Welcome to the Fit Small Business Zero Training Course. In the last two lessons, we discussed how to add customers and suppliers manually. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to import customer and supplier contacts in Zero. To follow along with me, log into your Zero account now, or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Zero. You can also click this link to access our full Zero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. The steps for importing customers and suppliers are exactly the same, but the type of information that you need to include is different. We will discuss the information you should include for customers first and then suppliers. There are two ways that you can enter contacts into Zero. You can enter them manually, or you can upload the information via spreadsheet. Since we discussed the first option in our previous lessons, this lesson will focus on importing contacts via a spreadsheet. To do this, you'll use an import template. This is a spreadsheet provided by Zero that specifies the data you need to include and where to include it. Whether you are converting from another accounting software or not, importing via a spreadsheet will cut your time in half compared to manually entering contacts. The import template for customers and suppliers is exactly the same. However, there are certain fields that we will focus on for customer contacts only. Let's discuss the fields that you will complete for your customer contacts and how to format that information. Here is the spreadsheet that we need to complete to prepare our information for import. The only field that is required is contact name, the very first field here. However, it will save you time later on if you import all of the information that you have for each customer. The next column is account number. If you assign account numbers to your customers, you want to enter that information in this field. This field can be a combination of letters and numbers. Email address. You want to enter the email address that you use to contact your customer in this field, along with your primary contact's first and last name in these next two fields. The essay attention to and the next several fields all pertain to your customer's address information. So in these fields, you want to include the address that you should use to send invoices and other correspondence to your customers. The next three fields include the contact information for phone number, fax number, and the mobile or cell number. Be sure to format these columns exactly as you see here with the dashes in between the numbers. In the Skype name field, you want to go ahead and enter your customer's Skype ID. This will come in handy should you decide to communicate with your customer face-to-face via Skype. The AR tax code column is where the sales tax rate is different from the default sales tax rate. Then you want to go ahead and enter the sales tax rate for a customer in this field. Please note that you must enter the exact sales tax name that you have set up in Zero. So for example, here we have LA County as the tax name here. Head over to our How to Set Up Sales Tax lesson to learn how to set up and track sales tax. Click here to access this lesson. Enter your customer's website address here in this field. In the discount field, you want to be sure and indicate the discount. Your customer receives a discount on everything that they buy from you. Then enter that discount rate in this field and it will be applied to all future transactions for this customer. You can enter up to 2 decimal places in this field and notice that there is no need to enter the percent sign. Due date sales day. If you have set up special payment terms for a customer, enter them in this field. Otherwise, you can leave this field blank and the default payment terms for all customers will apply. You want to complete the due date sales term column only if you've entered information in the due date sales day column since they go together. Otherwise, leave this column blank. Sales account. Complete this field only if the sales for a customer will not be tracked in the default sales account setup in the organization and financial settings. Please note, just enter the account code only, the numeric portion of the account, in this field as we have done. Sales tracking option 1 and 2. Complete these fields only if you have set up tracking categories. otherwise leave these fields blank. To learn more about how you can track sales by cost center, department, or location, check out our Reporting in Xero course. Click here to access this lesson. Branding theme. If the branding theme for this customer differs from the default branding theme that you set up in the How to Set Up Invoices lesson, then enter the name of the branding theme that you'd like to set up for this customer here. Otherwise, you can leave it blank. And finally, default tax sales. Complete this field only if the sales tax is different from the default that was previously set up. Please note, if you have not set up sales tax rates, then you must do that before importing sales tax rates information in this template. Click here to access this lesson. Let's talk about the information that you need now to import supplier contacts. Contact name, similar to customer contacts, is the only required field in this template. So in this column, go ahead and enter the name of the business that you purchase products and services from. Account number. If you have an account number that your supplier has assigned to you, enter that information here. This field can be a combination of letters and numbers. Email address field, you want to go ahead and enter the contact email address that you have for your supplier. And you want to go ahead and enter your primary contact's first name and last name in these next couple of columns here. These next group of columns is basically the information that you need to use to send payment via check or other correspondence to your suppliers. So you want to indicate who this information should be sent directly to. So for example, the accounting department, and then indicate the main address in one column, for example, what we have here with the numeric and the street name. And then if there's any additional information like suite number or floor, you can use these additional columns for that information. And then of course, don't forget to enter your city, state, and zip code. These next three columns, you want to go ahead and enter the contact phone number, fax number, and mobile number that you have for your supplier. Again, we've got a field similar to customer contacts where you can also indicate the Skype name or ID. Bank account name. In order to use the batch payments feature, you must enter the name of your supplier's bank in this field. You can learn more about how batch payments work in the How to Set Up Suppliers lesson. Click here to access this lesson. The bank account number column and the bank account particulars column go along with the bank account name for the batch payments. So in the bank account number column, you want to be sure and enter the routing number and the account number of your supplier's bank account where you need to send payments to. The bank account particulars column requires the type of account that you are using to send payment. That could be a business checking account, a business money market account, etc. Tax number type. This field goes hand in hand with the next one, tax number. In this column, you want to indicate the type of tax number that you have received from your supplier. So in this column, for example, we have EIN, which stands for Employer Identification Number. And then in the next column, we have that actual tax ID number formatted accordingly. Accounts payable tax code name. If the AP tax code for a supplier differs from the default established in the How to Set Up a Chart of Accounts lesson, then enter the name of the tax code that should apply to AP for this supplier in this column here. In the next column, you want to enter your supplier's website address if you have this information. Be sure that you include the HTTP colon and the two backslashes. Discount. If you receive a discount on all purchases from this supplier, go ahead and enter the discount rate in this field. You can enter a number up to two decimal places, and there is no need to enter the percent sign. Due date bill day. If you have received special payment terms from a supplier, enter them in this field. Otherwise, you can leave this field blank and the default payment terms for all suppliers will apply. The due date bill term field goes along with the due date bill day column. So for this particular example, this supplier allows this company to pay on the 30th of the current month. Purchases account. If you track purchases, enter just the account code from your chart of accounts in this field. If you don't track your purchases, you can leave this column blank. Purchase tracking option 1 and 2. Complete these fields only if you have set up tracking categories. Otherwise, you can leave these fields blank. To learn more about how you can track purchases by cost center, department, or location, check out our Reporting in Xero course. Click here to access this lesson. Branding theme. If the branding theme for this supplier differs from the default branding theme set up in the How to Set Up Invoices lesson, enter the name of the branding theme for the supplier here. Otherwise, you can leave this field blank. And finally, default tax bills. If you don't want to use the default tax rate that we set up in the How to Set Up Invoices lesson, then you can set up a special tax rate for purchases made from a supplier in this column. You want to enter the name of the tax rate as we have done in this field. Before we proceed to the next step to import our customer and supplier contacts, I want to share some tips with you for importing customer and supplier contacts into Xero. The first tip is you can put all customer and supplier contacts on the same import template. So there is no need to create two separate templates for customers and supplier contacts. Tip number 2, you can import up to 1,000 supplier and customer contacts at one time. If you have more than 1,000 contacts, you can put them in a separate template and import the remaining contacts or enter them manually. Tip number 3, do not make any changes to the header row. You want to keep all of the columns, even if you do not plan to use them all. So when I say header row, I am referring to this very first row, row 1 of the template. You do not want to make any changes to that row, and you don't want to delete any of the columns. Tip number 4, do not change the order of the columns. And finally, as I mentioned earlier, you want to make sure that you include the contact name for every import. So the very first column, as I mentioned, is the only required column and it must be included. Otherwise, the import will not work. All right, let's head over to Xero and walk through the steps on how we can import this information. To import our customer and supplier contacts in Xero, you want to click on the contacts and then go ahead and select all contacts. This screen, click on import. The import contact screen is broken down into 3 steps. The first step we've already completed where we downloaded our contacts template file. So to download this template, which we've already done, you can click on this link and save it to your computer. Step 2 is to prepare the template, which is what we just did together. So that will either consist of you entering the information manually or copying and pasting it from another template if you currently have an accounting software program that you're working with. So now we are on step 3, which is to import the updated template file. So you want to go ahead and click on the browse button to locate the file that we've saved. Once you've located your import file, you should see the name of the file to the right. Make sure it has the .csv format at the end. Please note that in addition to importing new contacts, you can also update information for existing contacts. When doing so, you will need to let Xero know how you want to handle any empty fields for existing contacts. And you've got one of 2 options. You can either have Xero ignore the empty fields, select this first option, or you can have Xero delete the existing information for any fields that are empty in the template. To learn more about how to update multiple contacts at once, click the link below. So once you've made your selections, we are ready to proceed with the import. So go ahead and click the import button and it will take us to the screen where we have one last opportunity to review the information that will be imported before the final import. So within this screen, Xero provides us with the action that will be taken once we complete the import. The total number of contacts is listed here. And then it's broken down between new contacts, versus updated contacts. You also may have some warnings here. So warning simply is just a heads up to you from Xero about certain information in the data. But this information will still be imported if you would like it to be. So once you have confirmed that this information matches your spreadsheet, you can go ahead and proceed with the import by clicking the Complete Import button. If for some reason you need to make some changes or this is just completely incorrect, you want to go ahead and click that Go Back button and make the changes that you need to make. Don't forget that when you import your contacts, they will show up in the All Contacts group in Xero. Xero will categorize your contacts as either customers or suppliers after you have entered a transaction, like an invoice or a bill, for the contact. That wraps up the lesson on how to import customers and suppliers in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course, or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.